It's absolutely magnificent to have you here with us today in Milton Keynes. Have you been enjoying meeting fans?
Yeah, well, I always enjoy meeting fans because, well, it's not often you walk into a building where almost everybody likes you. Usually there are a lot of people who couldn't give a hoot about you, the odd one who doesn't like you, and some who loathe you. So to go to one place where everybody thinks you're okay is a nice feeling.
Obviously you've been meeting a large number of Doctor Who fans today and in general. Have you had any particularly memorable fan encounters?
Well, they're all memorable because for them it's an important moment. And it's, especially with children, it's always a great pleasure to see the dawning light in a child's eyes when they, well, first of all, who's this big person my mum and dad are making me? Then it dawns on them who you are. And that's a nice feeling.
Doctor Who is a series that captures the hearts and imaginations of young children and adults alike. Everyone loves it. Why do you think that is? What is it about this series?
How many times have you asked that question of people? It's a question that has no answer. It is because it is. If I could give you the reasons, then we could go away and make 100 other programs like it. It was something that just captured the imagination at the time. And the proof of the pudding is that, having been off screen for over a decade, it came back and has found exactly the same degree of affection and commitment. It is a magic formula, and it's worked.
Talking about your own experiences on the show, can you just talk us through your first day on set, how it felt to step into those very impressive shoes?
You're implying that I can remember. To be honest, I can't remember the first day. I remember it all, in a way, as just being the best time I ever had in a television studio. Because usually you're hanging around a lot in a TV studio, waiting to do your bit. In my case, I was in everything, so there was no hanging around. I was just being the Doctor all day and every day, with a cast of great actors, because they always cast it well. So it was just like being paid to play cowboys and Indians, you know, good fun.
Each Doctor has brought something unique and wonderful to the role. What do you think you brought?
Me. That's it. It's for other people to say what I brought. I don't know what I brought. I brought myself. I've learnt the lines, I brought myself.
You say you can't remember your first day, but looking back, do you have any particularly special or fond memories from set? Anything that you just always smile about when you think?
No, they were all. Every single moment was like that. I'm sure there were standout moments, but off the top of my head, I can't pluck one out of the air, I'm afraid.
Doctor Who has got so many fantastic elements. One of them, of course, is the villains. Do you have a favourite? Fans always have theirs.
It's always the one you're working with, isn't it? The Daleks work. I mean, they're hell to film with because, you know, they can't go very fast, so you have to run very slowly away from a Dalek. And, you know, we'll shoot it 20 times so the Dalek looks right when it's moving, and irrespective of what you do. I'd like to have done a really good story with the Master, because I like the kind of one-to-one thing with a, you know, like Sherlock Holmes and Moriarty. I think the Doctor and the Master. So certainly on the, I'm doing Big Finish audios at the moment, which are Doctor Who on audio, and I'm enjoying doing the ones with Davros at the moment.
Again, fans really love the audio stories. Can you tell us a little bit about what's coming up? I mean, what are you recording at the moment?
I'm not recording anything at the moment. I'm not doing any for a couple of months now. I recorded quite a few at the beginning of the year that should be coming out soon, but I can't remember a thing about them.
Like you say, Doctor Who, it went away, but magnificently it came back. Have you been watching the new series, and what do you think of Matt Smith as our current Doctor?
I love Matt Smith. Matt Smith is brilliant. For me, he's exactly the Doctor, because I know he's a young man, because I've been told what his age is. But he has old in him. He looks young, but he has an inner old, which is so right for the Doctor. And I don't believe he's acting, which is a tribute to an actor. He's just being the Doctor. And the scripts are fantastic. So, yeah, I'm enjoying every second of it.
I mean, I think fans are very excited to see what's going to happen with the very special anniversaries we have coming up. There's a lot of talk about bringing some of the old faces back. Would you like to be involved in that? Do you think it would be nice to get some of the past Doctors back for a special episode?
Of course it would be nice, but whether it's a logical thing to do or not, I don't know. Well, I'll just make my point for you here. Okay? So how you would get that back, logically, as the doctor, I can't work out. I did that 30 years ago. All these talks about tachyon energy. I've been damaged by the time warp. Ah. Go on and make something new and exciting. But if they asked me back, of course I would. I think it'd be quite nice to come back and do a guest role as somebody quite other than the doctor. You know, to come back as just somebody in the background who looks at, just walk past Matt Smith and just do a double take and walk on. I think that would be quite camp. But well, I've heard nothing. So whether it'll happen or not, I don't know.
To anything else at the moment? Have you got anything else going on in the pipeline?
Yes, I've got a play which opens next week in Lincoln and is touring till the end of August, called The Final Test, a comedy, which I'm doing with an actor called Peter Raymer, who used to be in Emmerdale Farm. And in the autumn, I'm touring with a play I did last year called Woman in White, which is a Wilkie Collins adaptation. And at Christmas, I'm in Bournemouth in pantomime. I'm playing the Dame. So if you're in Bournemouth, come and see me in Panto.
We absolutely can't wait for that. I'm going to let you get back to fans here today, but for any fans that couldn't make it here, is there anything you'd like to say to them? Do you have any messages?
Yeah, you missed out, didn't you? You should have come. It's been really good, and you weren't here. Come next time.